Hello everyone, welcome back to the Darkest Dungeon. In the last episode, we did a very lucrative pair of runs with some of the most stressed out people that we have, but we got a couple of people leveled up, which is very nice indeed, and we have a lot of heirlooms to spend. Now, what are we going to spend them on? Good question. Good question indeed. The guild needs upgrading because we have level 4 people and we need to get up to rank 4. We have got enough crests, but only just. We've got probably got enough busts. Let's see what the exchange rate is. So if I exchange 3 busts, will give me 1 of those. I need 20, by the way, so that's going to be 60, which is basically all of them. 4, 6, yeah, so it is 3-1. So I think our job there is just going to be to get more portraits, or just a shitload more crests so that we can trade those. And also, do we need the back blacksmith? Yes. Very much so, which means we need a lot more deeds. So we have enough crests, and that it does seem to be the highest drain as well as the highest income. So that balances out, but we also use those the most to, you know, swap people over. We have a couple of new names. Let's see who we have to rename. There's only Senlis, the new antiquarian, and our new healer, which is the occultist flavour. This might as well be Erasmus. Nocturnal, you say? Nah, it's not too great. But again, a healer class with low speed, it might actually be beneficial. And the other person here, this will be Sir Gyrus. Now, that's my brother. Why is he one of the last people to go in? Didn't really talk to him about it, basically, and then I did, and then he is, so that's pretty cool. Welcome to the party, both of you. We do have another couple of spaces in the roster, and we might as well see what we have available. We've seen this, so I'm tempted to just get another one because it's so cheap, and then on the next one we'll have
foolishly seeking fortune and glory.
Foolishly indeed. This is not what you're going to get. You're probably going to get dead or at least stressed out and syphilis. What should we do? What shall I do? We should go to the cove. That was probably what we were thinking at the end of the last episode, so we'll sort by level and we'll probably just take the usual. Maybe we should take some of the level 3 people to the cove. Now, the cove has a lot of protection. So rather than punching people, we want to be able to, like, debuff people, which basically means we have to take Jekrid. A level 2 is probably not going to work. We don't really have many. I mean, we could take an occultist in an offensive capacity, which, given that one of them is Pete and one of them is Bagel, is our only choice. But, I mean, it's only really plague doctors that do good poison damage. I suppose highwaymans do have bleed. It's damage over time that we're looking for. Tim has bleed. Actually, Tim with bleed out, if it bleeds, that one would be really good for this. We can iron swan to hit the back. So let's take Tim. I'm really enjoying Tim's character and, of course, Doug's equivalent character, which is basically exactly the same now I think about it. Oh, that could be really good. Sorry, Tim. I'm swapping you out for Doug. Because Doug, instead of Wicked Hack, is going to use Bleed Out, which does debuff ourselves. But the more bleeds we can stack up on one of those awful targets at the front that we hate, the quicker it'll fall apart. We need a healer, which is going to be Ash. Ash, are you okay? Yes. We're going to have we need some other sort of DPS. And I mean, really, it doesn't matter at this stage. I kind of want to take Raikoud of it. That Highwayman is far too low level for this. Penelope Puddles could be a good choice. But a level 2? Yeah, sure. No. You're going to be doing the dancing back and forth. And I wish we had another Grave Robber, but we don't. And Martinus is currently getting his syphilis removed. Well, it's going around. I suppose there's only 28 people and they can get quite lonely in the town when other people are adventuring, so that does make some sort of sense. Miri, you have a lot of bleeds, actually. Yes, that seems legit. So your thing is going to be where you do the dancing forward and running back. So you can do that from any position. And then the finale from the back. So you need to be... You need to be where Miri needs to be. Which is a shame. You can do that from all three. Well, that's the only one you can't do. What if I did that? Now you can be in the second position. Oh. Lick wounds could be okay. But I don't think we need it with a Vestal healer. Maybe we should unlock this. We have got enough money for it. And having some stuns on the first three... Yeah, let's do that. We'll put Miri in for... well, actually, I clicked on the blacksmith without realising, but we do need to do this on everybody anyway. So we really should. You're at our front, so you definitely want the... well, that's one, two... Miri, and... Who else did we choose? Hello? Okay. What? Oh, Penelope. Where's Penelope? There you are. Okie dokie. Come on. Let's not leave the viewers watching. Oh, wait. That's what they're supposed to be doing. Let's not leave them waiting. No, I'm not clicking on this. Megistos is meditating. That's probably for the best. Right. We will take... Ooh. Just checking everyone's upgraded as well as intending to unlock Miri's... Miri, where have you gone? There you are. Blackjack. Which I'll fully upgrade. We were spending a lot of money on this, actually, which is probably not hugely sensible, but... Right. That's really good. That's okay, but I don't necessarily want to use it to... I can't afford all of this, so I'm just going to get these to level 1. Just because the debuffs and the self-buffs are really good. But not too happy with spending the rest of the money to get the rest of the way. Now Miri is in the right position to go here and take this. That's good. That's pretty good. Yeah, there are some beasts down there, and that synergizes with the mark. So let us take all our trinkets back and make sure that our Houndmaster has the one that they need. Bit of speed could be nice. Scouting chance. If torched below 51, I'm not here for that. We need bleed stuff, really, on the bleed units. But that should probably go on our... Let's do it this way. That goes on there. And our melee accuracy, right. That is pretty much exactly what I want that to be. 25% damage versus human. Or dodge. Or damage. There may be another bleed something somewhere. So we will look for it. More damage versus beast couldn't hurt anybody, really. Actually, let's check this. This is a ranged axe. Right, so the hound is a ranged thingy. That's really good to know. Because it means that the Houndmaster can use the ranged skills bonus. Whether we want to is a slightly different question. Position 4, not necessarily useful. Yes, that one. Minus 4 dodge is not brilliant, but the Houndmaster actually starts with quite a lot of dodge already, so that's pretty cool. I might just take more damage versus beast. Where did that go? Human? Beast? There's a lot of Eldritch down there, but I don't think we can use that. I mean, I don't think we have one. Let's do that. More accuracy on range skills could be okay. It definitely mean that our dog is much less likely to miss. You're a fast, stabby, bleedy thing. Stun skill could be decent. Actually, I'll tell you what. You get the stun skill, because you just unlocked a stun thing that therefore we definitely want to use. So it really makes sense to have that. And another 30% on bleed skill. And even less... that actually counteracts that. So we'll do that. And Vestal only. We have got the 33% heals, which is great. Less stress damage and less speed. It's actually beneficial so that the Vestal can go after everybody else has taken some damage. And then there's another... I don't think we're going to need so much HP that we want to take the one that causes us extra stress, so I'm just going to take the one that allows us to do... Pardon me? I thought it was that one. It's this one. That seems good. Yes, 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 yes. Everyone's equipped. We will provision with the rest of our money. It is a medium mission, so hold on to your hats. We're going to be here for a while. We do have our inventory half full already, but these will disappear as we go along. Maybe we should take a bit less because there's some medicinal herbs here. Yeah, well, we'll take enough for 4 hungers, but I won't take any extra for healing with. Probably want 3 of those at least. And then some bandages. Oh, and some torches. Torches are, I understand, a central part of the game. So, I suppose we'll all learn together how this game works. That looks good to me. I'd like to have a lot of torches for a medium mission. We have firewood so that we can de-stress at some point. Thralls will explode if left for too long. Okay, they will explode. What does that mean? Is that a good explode or a bad explode? Right, where are we going? We're going to do 3 protective wards. We have to look absolutely everywhere, which is a problem, because normally if it's like 90% of rooms or 100% of room battles, it will end at some point during the mission. Well, I suppose it's equivalent to 100% of room battles. Don't just stand there whilst you're talking. Talk and walk. Talk and chew bubblegum at the same time. I have some food already, so that's really good. To be spent. So we're going to have to go to everything, irrespective of whether we care about it. We're surprised. Are you kidding me? And they get to start. Alright, well, you haven't got anything except moving, so... You're all going to get de-accuracied, if possible. Everyone got de-accuracied, so you're going to miss. Yep. See, I called it Blackjack or Hounds... Well, what have we got? Eldritch, 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 Eldritch. Well, I was hoping at least one of these was a beast, but apparently a fucking squid is not... That's not a beast. It's obviously a beast. It's made of... Okay, whatever. Bleeds. Right, protection. No protection on these, so we will just kill them with ouches. Which means we're going to do the target whistle. Which one do I hate the most? It doesn't actually tell me their accuracy, but I think it's going to be this one. So we'll set ourselves up. We may take some damage on the first round, but we'll be okay. I'm not sure whether I want to finale with this unit before having done the... Ow. The thing that isn't finale. That's good timing. The solo, which moves you forwards. I assume one plays off the other, but I guess it can't hurt too much. It does... It's bad. It does do damage. It doesn't do damage. Let's just move. We shouldn't. The reason I'm not moving is that I want to avoid swapping units around a lot. That's not very good. So we're actually doing ourselves a bit of a misservice. Because we're spending so much time trying to get ourselves back in position, because most of our units need their positions to work. I think we just start bleeding. I kind of want you to be in the second position at least. You can only be in the first book. If it bleeds, does do damage as well as bleed damage. So you're on 2 left to live. Maybe I shouldn't have attacked that one. Let's do this. That's 3 on that. Plus, well, it's not an extra bleed, but you're both bleeding. Okay, good. Can we stun something? Maybe we should. Can't stun that, which is a shame. These are the same, so we'll just do that one. Again, it does some damage. We just keep adding damage and see what happens at this stage. The more accuracy they have. Well, that only lasts a round. That's not very good at all. Right, we need to rethink our positioning here. We definitely have to move Vivaphonics there, because well, you're the only one left to go. So, oh, you've got to go. You're going to die, so you get to dodge that attack. Fine. We definitely need to move you, because Penelope Puddles there is just useless in that position, which is a shame. But it is what it is. This is very, very painful. Let's just attack stuff. I'm not even going to bother with... How are you resisting this much bleed? 70% though. We should have brought a Blight character. That's a shame. Well, you live and learn. What are you on? 2 damage. Just kill something. Get it out of there. Can you work from this position? I think you can. So we should be okay. This has not started well. This initial surprise has just scrambled us so successfully. I'd just rather keep this not acting than try to kill that, because the stress is probably going to be the worst thing for us right now. I think we just try and heal everybody. Yeah, 5s. A party heal for 5 means we really don't need to be worrying about our HP. I think that seems fair to say. That is a great amount of damage. Plus the bleed, it's dead. Alright, sweet. So everyone's going to get a bit of speed and accuracy. That's what we wanted to start with, but obviously we couldn't. You're dead. The amount of damage that bleed out does up front is actually stupendous. It's a really, really good amount of damage. Finally, we've succeeded here, though. You can't do... Push on to the task's end. Yeah, you kind of need to be in the third position. Right, can you not be surprised anymore? We didn't bring any keys. So I guess we just open this? Well, it is what it is. I mean, you think it's traps, I get it, but it's still got stuff in it, right? It's not trapped and then empty. I mean, why would it be trapped if it were empty?
It's a torch. Now it must be carried home.
It's a torch, we're not carrying it home. No surprise. Okay, good. Right, this is how we do it. If it bleeds, everything's 70% bleed resist. That's outrageous. We just kill it in one hit, and it got bled anyway, so I guess we're okay. We try and spread some damage around here. Let's try and get this done quickly, I think. Sea breeze, that's healing, right? Yes, okay. That means you didn't do any stress. I don't mind that. You can do that as much as you like. Because our healer's great. Ash is here to play. Everything's Eldritch. What's our damage here? We've got 9. So at the high end of our roll, we could kill that. But although, we only need to do 6 damage, which is the low end of our roll, which makes all the difference. Or we could just crit, get everyone a little bit of stress relief, and kill that one outright and don't even leave a corpse. That was actually plan A, but I didn't mention it. Yeah, you crit yourself, who doesn't need it. Okay, I'm feeling a lot better about this because this round has turned out to be really, really good. Despite these hits, you know, it's not like we're... Ah, it does debuff us, actually. Less damage and less dodge for 3 rounds, that's okay. But we should be aware of that, and the fact that Miri appears to be critting like shit right now. Not like shit, but like hell, like a lot. What do we do about this, though? Blight resistant disease. We've got one of these, haven't we? And I don't really use it. But it is worth a lot more than... Nothing, really. Yeah, whatever. This, eliminate combat debuffs. Okay. Yeah, we're just going this way. Can we have 5 minutes? Without a fucking... Right, you go first. Okay. More accuracy, more crit. Use this opportunity. I know that they're surprised, not stunned. I'm aware, but just hold. Just bear with me on this. Just hold on to your hats. We're going to Iron Swan this. He's going to dodge. Okay. We're going to Target Whistle this. It's marked. It's got less prop. It's going to do us some stress, but we can camp to try and get rid of some of this stress. But we're not going to get rid of too much, I don't think, because, you know, if we get too much stress up front, there's only so much we can get rid of in the first place. Can I have a go? Oh yeah, of course I've had all my goes first. Kind of expecting some of these buffs to help, but I guess not. Right, everything is now less accurate. This does mean that Doug can't do the Iron Swan at the back there, but what we can do is just maybe nearly kill this. A crit is exactly what I was hoping for, and I didn't want to say it in case I don't want to say that I jinxed it. It's not like I'm a superstitious person, but at the same time, I don't want to say, I'm going to crit this, and then it didn't work, and I'm going, oh, it didn't work. Just seeming like you're relying on a crit. It doesn't sound like a good idea. Although, if you wanted to crit, that would be super duper. Wow, what? 16 dodge. That was probably just a low roll then, that's a shame. Kill that. You critted. I'm happy with that too. So you've got now a lot of bad stuff, but you can buff us from the back of him. That would be good too. This could get rid of half your health. You must have resisted the debuff, so I'm just going to see if I can get rid of you before you get to have a go. That would be swell. Oh, of course, I can't hit that. But I can hit this, which does bleed, but not very well. Yeah, that's exactly what I wanted, because this is slightly less likely to hit us. Still did, but you know, you got to play the odds. This is not great. I think I top everybody up a little bit. Just... because you don't know which one it's going to go for. Everyone gets a little bit of a buff. Because all the Jester's going to do now is assist in that regard, which will help you. You're going to die, so... please crit. Didn't crit. That's okay. I mean, the Vestal is sort of an average of the... occultist healer, really. You usually get a pretty decent heal. Perfect. Well, not perfect. I'd like to have got another heal in, but we'll survive. I want to get rid of some of this shit, because I want the portraits. Do you know what? We don't need busts, but we do need portraits, so we'll do that. I mean, that doesn't really help. Find victory. If we could find anything that can use anything from our inventory rather than just fighting all the time, that'd be swell. I bet there's another fight in here as well. We've actually fought a lot, considering all we've done is walked two rooms. We've fought three times in one room and two corridors. This is four times in two rooms. I think in this case you start with this. We don't want to get to the point where we have to move the Jester back. That was not fun. Right, what do we do here? You can hands rush that. You're not going to. You're going to target whistle it, because it's already had a go. But hopefully it won't have a go on the next turn, because we've got more speed now. Before us. And then hopefully... did I just see a spider? Maybe I didn't just see a spider. Don't let me use the anti-spider shout. Right, what are we doing here? I guess we could Iron Swan this and try and get rid of it. Why are you there? You're supposed to be there. What the heck? How long has that been the case? I didn't even notice. Maintain the offensive. Okay. Well, at least you're taking some damage. Maybe we got shuffled at some point and I didn't realise? I think the problem is because Penelope is at the back now. Oh, I'll tell you what happened. Penelope was there, then went back there. But you shouldn't have swapped round. I'm so confused. Whatever. Right, now you're going to do the solo, which will move you forward 1, 2, 3. We should put Ash in a position where Ash can actually heal us properly. I guess we hounds rush. That target whistle was slightly wasted, unfortunately, because we actually killed outright the thing that we wanted to use with it. But I suppose this does remove some protection, so that's worthwhile, provided it... yeah, it did take. You've also got plus 25 protection, so... oh, that's really good. Oh dear, here we go then. Spreading out this damage is actually slightly worse than it not spreading out this damage. A good crit, though. Because Ash can't just heal one thing... everything for a lot, right? We have to heal one thing at a time for a lot, or everything for a bit. Now everything's sort of back up to health, we can start thinking about doing a party heal again, but let's finale. What's the damage on it? What's this? 3. You are going to die from the bleed, but you will get an attack in. I think what we actually want to do is we have to... oh, God. We basically have to do this, because I want the... I want Doug to have a decent go. But now Ash is back in the wrong position. But Ash is going to be doing party heals from now on, so that does actually work. For 5 as well, that's really a decent amount. It's going to keep everybody topped up. I think if Ash can continue to do heals for 5, we're going to be on top of it. Right, so that one's dead next turn, so we don't need to concentrate on it. Ah, that'd be what happened. So that's got a move that I hadn't realised. I must have just not noticed that it had happened. I mean, we could bleed out this. That's a really strong attack, but because it's got so much protection, and it didn't actually get bled. That turned out to be a problem. We can harvest again, so we should. I know that one was going to die, but maybe, we stack another bleed on that. It's just one bleed at the moment, actually. Yes, okay. That's okay. Keep doing that. You kill that. 13 damage is actually a lot, considering how much protection that thing had. I mean, this is a strong attack, but if it bleeds, that bleed out, super strong attack. But it's still, that 75% armor took a lot away from it, but that final attack on that, that's what we want to do a lot more of. This doesn't really help us, but, I mean, it literally helps us in the sense that now we have some help, but... Oh, you're dead anyway. Okay. Let's put people back in the right place, shall we? I kind of don't need those, but I would like to take them, so if we could actually find something that we need to do stuff with. No holy water. Fair enough. Right. That's that horrible area of the horrible place dealt with. That's taken forever. We're at half an hour and we've done 2 rooms. Well, I'm not cutting this episode. It's going to be a bloody long one. I know there was a lot of preamble today, I suppose. Look.
The light. The promise of safety.
Might as well do that. La la la. That was a trap. Well dodged, though. Fight. No fight. Our RNG on the generation of this dungeon has been particularly unfriendly. What is this, though? 50% protection, 61 HP, but it takes up 2 spaces. Then we've got these two, which do spear fishing, so they can really ruin our day. So I guess what we start off with is an Iron Swan to try and get rid of one of these. Or at least bring it down into getting rid of it range. We battle ballad everybody to try and increase our speed and crit. The crit is really nice. The accuracy is good for her there, but... What I'm also thinking... Oh, excuse me. What I'm thinking is that bit of extra speed means that we get to go first on each round, which can be really valuable. 3s is okay, but spreading out the healing is quite important. Fucking hell. Okay, so spearfishing actually brings you forwards, which is why our healer keeps ending up in the wrong damn place. It doesn't make sense now. Unfortunately, we only have one unit that can actually move forwards without taking a turn to do so. Which is you. I'm going to keep letting you do this. The buff is actually more important than I think many people might give it credit for. If it bleeds, what's your bleed resist? 80%. Really should have brought some blight, apparently. Really? That's very bad. Very bad roll, and now we're debuffed. Well. And that just saw heals. Oh, that might have been them. What is happening here? What is even going on? Right, you've got dodge but not protection. I just want to get rid of this because it keeps moving us around. That was fine. Does that bring you in range? Not really. I'm just going to have to do this. It's not good, but at least we can heal ourselves on the next round. Arterial pinch, it's another bleed, right? Well, we resisted it, so that's fine. We do have a buff to our bleed skill, don't forget. Did you bring a buff? No, but you've got your stun skill, which we haven't actually used too much of. 2 damage per round, 5 damage. Well, maybe we do this? That does bring you into death. Yeah, you're going to die, so that's fine with me. You need to heal yourself. For a lot, so that's really good. It wasn't even all your HP, and that was quite a lot of... Quite a big number. You can solo, so... You might as well. It does mean Doug doesn't get to do the close-up attack. Ow, that's actually quite a lot of damage. Holy shit. Good thing I brought that. If it bleeds, which it does. Yeah. 7 damage. Ha! Who else has got a high bleed attack? It's me. What's got 2 thumbs and a good bleed attack? Not you. You've got 2 weird pincer things. 8. Christ. We can keep on top of it for sure, but... Even so. Well, now we're in the wrong position again. Just move. I'd rather spend your move on not doing damage than your move on not doing healing. Can we yelp you? Try. Perfect. Right, so now you can heal you. Can you crit that? Just do nothing but crits. This is plus 33 and then plus 15. It seems... Like, why are you so bad? Is what I'm suggesting. Look, this is 5 to 7. And we did 6. And that's with 33% extra. That doesn't seem like it's working. Do you know what I mean? Right, we'll put this whistle on here. Debuff? Yeah, debuff. Then we'll do a bleed out. That's 10 damage, which is decent. Another bleed is great. You've got 10 damage left. You're going to pinch me for another 8 damage per round for bajillion rounds. Oh, you resisted it. Whew. Now you're going to heal yourself. Because Doug is not actually bleeding, so not imminently dead. And then you just do this again. It seems like there's a lot more bleeds that are happening to me than I had actually given it credit for. And can we yelp it? Yes. I want you to have it then. I mean, I kind of want it to die. Which is gonna. Tell with it. I thought we could maybe get Ash to have a go before we had to kill it, but really? I don't think that's gonna happen. We have had to throw away so much stuff. I'm using this though. Now that we're out of combat, we can't just heal as much as we like. Haven't found a single quest item, I'm just saying. We're gonna have to go in both directions to find them. So we're gonna have to backtrack a lot. 1, 2, 3, 4 there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, 4 there. It doesn't matter how you spin it. That's 4 backtracking there, 4 backtracking there. So, I mean, our hands are tied. We don't have any option. At least there's no fucking battle down here, though. Pardon my French, but zut alors, huh? Why are you in the right place? Oh, that's because I moved. So much just crap. You, probably you. 110, 80, 90. I have seen 110 fail. The Cove is turning out to be an extremely difficult dungeon. Spirits are lifted. It's no wonder it's still level 2, I suppose. Made clear. Quest location, presumably... It doesn't say room battle with quest location. So we'll do this way first, on the very slim off chance. Ash, it's a torch. On the very, very slim off chance that all 3 quest locations are in this direction. But at the very least, we know at least that we can get rid of one of our... fucking... bullshit. These don't even stack. That's the annoying thing. You think they'd stack. They're only little jars of crap. Right. Put that in there. The ward is now lit. Don't find these things when you haven't brought your pineal glands, of course. That would be too easy. We're going to come back this way, and we may have more inventory space. So I'm going to open that in the other direction. The way is but not lit. This. The path is clear. We require only the got some cash to follow it. And a torch. Didn't need to buy 2 stacks of torches. We haven't actually used more than 1 of the top stack. Because of the amount of fucking torches we found. So there's that. Pretty sure that's a... Oh. Why are we getting so surprised? Is this just the way the game... This may be the way the game amps up in difficulty, to be fair. Because it... Okay, we just got surprised and then immediately crit for more health than we had. Which is out-fucking-rageous. Jesus Christ. We could lose Doug on this just because of a random... This has been such a horrible, horrible run. I'm half tempted to just leave, you know? Just... You can't eat something. Okay. If it bleeds on... guess the one that hasn't been yet. You couldn't have crit or anything. Don't attack. Why are you there? Yes, that's where you're supposed to be. Okay. So confused by our party being in basically the right position. These are the only two that have really swapped around in any way that's a problem. You did move the resist, which is fine. If you could crit this, that'd be brilliant. Okay. That's not quite enough HP to actually call... This is stupid. Look, we've got 33% plus 15%, and that is one more HP than that unit's max HP heal. That is clearly not working, right? Is it just me? Shouldn't have given you that either. It seems ridiculous that 15 and then 33. I assume it's therefore 48% extra, not, you know, 15% off 33 on top. I mean, at this point it doesn't really matter. That's what we like to see. But still. Whatever 15% of 33 is, it still should be a third extra. Like, our max rolls should be giving us... I guess 8. Now I think about it. That's really good, actually. I'm trying to use these units in the wrong position as well, which is just... kind of useless. Well, I'm getting a bit salty, so maybe we should just... calm it. You're a buffed. You've got extra everything. Oh, Jesus. What have you got? 3 damage, 7. 5-3. So if we do that again, you're both in kill range. Singular strike. Excuse me? Alright, you're fucking guarded. Rank 1, 2 rounds. So we stun this. Stun resist 45%. Or you try it. Crit for 1. It is stunned, so that's a bonus. You're actually dead, which is what we were hoping for. And these two things are bleeded, and of course, Ash is at least in a position where they can do the damage that we want, the undamaged, the negative, the healing. It's called healing, don't forget that. Honestly, this is such a good attack that I'm just going to keep using it. It's got a lot of strength to it. I'm not above running away. Like, abandoning the quest. The fact that we've had so much combat already is just preposterous. Right? It's not... I don't feel like I am being melodramatic in saying the fact that we've got 4 pieces of combat in the first 2 rooms is too damn much combat. We will absolutely take that kill. Thank you for playing. Now we start party healing, because everyone's about the same distance from death. You've got this, which is horrible. We can remove it from a camp, I think. Alright, we've come out of this okay. Not brilliant, but okay. At least this one's bleed is not... yeah, sure. You know. It's not 8 per round for 3 rounds, which is just a ridiculous amount of bleed. Just keep stunning. So if we can halve that thing's damage output, that's basically like killing it twice as fast, right? We can't actually hit that, so we move. Seems like the sensiblest thing to do. It does give Ash another heal, which could have crit, but didn't crit. Thanks for playing. We're doing okay on HP, actually. It's a stress that's a bit of an issue. But this combat could have gone much worse than it actually did. Stop it. Stop talking. So as long as we get to go first, which we should do, because we've got such high speed. We did have such high speed. Nah, we didn't do that battle ballad before then, did we? That's okay. We resisted that. Just end it so that we don't have to live with this torment for any longer. Having a couple of extra stuffs is quite nice. Especially this bandage. I'm basically going to keep those. I mean, normally I would say I'd keep them for... I didn't want to move you. Why were you in move mode? That's really confusing. You are going to do that. Ah. A debuff. No, that doesn't matter. How does that help? That doesn't help anybody. Okay. I'm going to keep those bandages for in case we meet another one of those crab thingies. Because, Jesus Christ, I'd much rather have, excuse me, can we not do this?
Ancient traps. Quiet. Lie in wait.
Don't forget we can camp as well.
Thirsting for blood.
Look. We need to take something back with us, otherwise we're just going to be super salty that we even turned up. Oh, goodness. Do excuse me. Again. I've got a drink of water here, let's try that. Right then. We're nearly at the end. Right, no, fuck it, I'm not going back. I don't care about that curio, I am not doing two more fucking battles. Jesus Christ. So here's what I'm going to do. We're going to walk all this way. And then we're going to come up to here. Now, I want to pick up the stuff that's in that curio. But I don't want to bleed, because it's a barnacle-y chest. Minus 12 dodge until camp. Or we better camp. I was going to say, we're going to camp. So, just open it. Okay. You can use a shovel to make that lucrative. I don't want it to be lucrative because I haven't got any space. So I just have to chuck it all away anyway. So all I did there was hope that we were going to get a... what's a curio there that we didn't open? I don't remember. Maybe it was something that I thought would... It's probably one of those statues. Yeah, I'm not going to use up a shovel just to do that. So we're going to camp here. Takes up some space. We're going to get less stress and more HP. Now everyone's fully healthy and is we're feeling better. I think we're down somewhere. Do we have a thing that removes mortality debuff? No, but that's valuable. Pray. No. All companions. Heal 50%. Oh. It doesn't actually remove the debuff. It just... If you have it. Okay, so who do we want to put into stress relief? Because we're going to have to get somebody down in stress. We'll do this. Very much worthwhile. So you two should come out of this okay, or at least not flip out, which is the important thing. We'll do a Hound's Watch, because we've got surprised twice on this run. This has been a horrible run for RNG, unless they've, buffed the way that the levels just show up, I suppose. That's 8% crit. Could be nice. It's 3, though, which means we only have 2 left. Which means we're going to have to... We've got an encourage here. I'm wondering whether it would be better to have 2 units with below 50 stress, or 1 unit with, like, below 20 stress. Well, nearly 20. And I'm thinking what we do is we encourage you... Now you're both below 50%. That could be good, actually. It does cost 3. I was going to say we do this to get our main DPS doer more crit chance. For 4 combats. But now I'm thinking maybe we just try not to stress out completely. But now I think if we do more... I like the idea of 8% crit. That's a lot. Especially on that unit, which is already... very crit heavy. So we've got a space in our inventory. We did bring enough stuff for this obstacle. So we shall.
Another mariner. Another misfortune.
Indeed. Stashed heirlooms. More portraits. The fact they only stack up to 3 is probably the reason we never have any of them. We haven't got a trap coming up. No, but there's a room battle with treasure. So we will crack a torch before we go in. Half tempted to just get rid of one of these stacks of torches that we're not using. Maybe. If the treasure's good, we will do that. And I'm also tempted to use the dog shoots. I think I might use the dog shoots then. So of course you get to go first and undo everything that I just did. But consider, if we hadn't done everything that we just did in the camping, everything that they do to us will be stacked on top of the stuff that everything else has done to us. So this was as much a way of having a bit more of a buffer before we go crazy. Good dog. Right. I will actually start off with this. No, this. Can you reach the back? Yes. You're going to Iron Swan, so I'm going to attack. I'm going to set the dog up to do DPS on this unit, on the premise that Iron Swan will finish off that unit fairly neatly. Three crit is okay, and it's just a stress, and there's a debuff of bleed. Oh, and a stun. Okay, perfect. Well, Iron Swan this. Well, that's one of the two that we need. Although we could still roll not quite enough. Stop doing that, though. Just saying. Well, we need to step you back, so... Hopefully we don't need to heal too much before you get to step back and then do another thing. That's okay. I'm going to keep doing this. I know it's not ideal, but the fact that these things keep moving us is a terrible thing, which I hadn't realised was the case. In the last episode, I was talking about how it's good to have a selection of units that can do well in different positions, especially if you have one that's moving around, which I had actually forgotten, even though it was my own advice. Which we haven't got. Although, in fairness, I had somewhat considered it because I was thinking that Ash here could heal from the different positions that Ash would end up in. Thank you for doing that on the first round when it was important rather than on the second round when you didn't need to do it. Oh, wait, I'm being facetious again. Right, you move because you don't need to not move, if that makes sense. But unfortunately, with this thing pulling us around all the time, basically, we needed to come into this with way more movement resist than we thought we did. How many? There's one round left, so on the next turn, we're going to have to start... replace that mark. Unfortunately, the Jester going first means that the Jester ends up at the front before the Hellion gets to do any attacks. Divine Grace yourself. Get some healing. At least you can't dodge a heal, right? If I hit that, it'll hit that. That's got 19 HP. We're not going to do much damage on that, but we could bleed it, so we'll try. Oh, we crit! Impressive indeed. So that's a bit of extra damage, which is really useful. Now it's in range of that. Now do we put the mark back on and waste... I say waste around. Oh, let's just finale it. Oh, we can't. We could kill that. We should try, I think. Very close indeed. No bleed on it, unfortunately. You can't do this from here, though. But you can stun that. Or we can do this. This is on 3 and it's got 8. So let's see what we end up with. I did kill that other one. No one got bled. Now we yelp because we didn't do the extra damage that we hoped to on that. I think. Or do we just if it bleeds it? And if it bleeds that, could do half its health. I'm tempted to go for the stun just to reduce the damage output on the next round. I could resist it, of course. It didn't, but it could have. Which is a bit risky, I grant you. But... Yeah, reducing... Knowing that we couldn't kill either of them, it seemed to make most sense to reduce the damage output of that one, and that's actually very nearly dead, which is unfortunate how close it is to being dead without actually being dead. And it's also unfortunate how this thing manages to move our Vestal every single fucking time it does anything. Not that I'm bitter. Now you're in death range. You're going to die, so that's okay. You're going to heal yourself again. You can't. Step back. I don't think we're going to have to run away from this. Stop doing that! What a fucking waste of a turn. I could have given everybody a bit of extra HP just now. We really need to give this Hellion, or just in general, the Hellions, the one where they charge, this one. It's forward one. And works from any position, which is so useful. It debuffs yourself, which is also a big problem, but... If this thing just keeps pulling my Vestal forwards, I'm wondering if it cannot target the back. In which case, we have to remember that the Vestal is going to have to stay at the back. But like, the fact that the Vestal was there and then immediately got pulled back is just ridiculous. It's very frustrating. I appreciate that I sound quite salty right now. I'm a bit upset. Mostly because it's all bullshit. and I hate everything. But it just, I think we're doing okay, right? I don't think we're in such a big deal. Try and get the vessel to go first if we can. Can we just, is it stunned? Oh, why are you so slow? I intentionally gave the vessel a low speed, and now it's too fucking slow. We might come back for that. It's not going to be too stressy. Another obstacle. I'm glad I didn't use a thing to open that. And there is a secret door. We did bring a key. So we'll use one more shovel here. Is there another obstacle? Yes, there is. We brought exactly enough obstacles. But I was thinking of using a shovel, if you recall, to open the... Oh, there's a quest location here. To open that barnacle chest. Which, if we had done, would have meant we didn't have enough... Why are you on move again? This doesn't make sense. I keep clicking on a unit to move that unit, and it turns out I'm already in a move sort of context, and then I move the unit that I already had selected. Why is move already selected? I didn't press it. Right, this is good. Ignored that curio because we didn't have any space. Use our final shovel, which was for once the correct number of shovels to bring. So this quest location. So I think we just end the quest as soon as we can. Our HP is so dismal right now. Probably should have done more with these bandages, but I was expecting way more things that do bandage, that require bandages. There isn't even a battle here, actually. So maybe what we do here is we continue adventuring and we come back. We don't need scouting. To this curio, to this treasure here. We open it up, we gather what we can, and then we leg it. It doesn't matter if we take HP damage or debuffs. Only stress is going to be a problem at this point, so what we do is we use Penelope here, who maybe we should have brought like a higher resolve character for this. In fact, why don't you open this as well? Empty. Just make Penelope do everything that could cause the stress or HP damage. It's trapped! It was a trap. Resisted that. Two curios and a secret room. There's no more battles. So I'm quite happy to stress everybody out and piss everybody off. Walking backwards and forwards. This has turned out to be a surprisingly... victorious run. I was genuinely convinced that we were going to completely screw it up. Ash has successfully failed to do that for quite some time. Yeah, do what you want. There's still booty inside.
If only treasure could staunch the flow.
Pretty nice.
Otherworldly corruption.
It can, because that treasure had a trinket in it which will help our plague doctors. Right, there's nothing in here, so I am going to go... Good freaking grief. Am I right? Look at that shit. Okay. Everyone's level... Alright, you're level 4. Hemophilia, that's really bad. That's... okay, I don't care about that. That's okay. That's pretty good. Right, so you, Miri, are going in for disease removal. But I'm going to call this quite early because of how that's taken so damn long. Where's Miri? Miri. Level 4 now, well done. Medical ward, get rid of this because it's terrible. Imagine that, and then there's that eight point bleed per turn thingy? Why have you still got syphilis? Because I don't care about it. Yeah. Okay. Well, that's going to be it for this run, because for this episode indeed, because of how horrible it turned out to be. Oh god, you're level 3 now. Why are you still... Drink. Yeah, that's it for this episode. Thank you for watching. I'm gonna skedaddle because you've been watching for the past best part of an hour of your life that you're not getting back. So thank you for spending that hour with me, and I hope that you will spend the next 30-45 minutes in the next episode. But until then, do take care. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day. Good day. Bye-bye.